This animation is similar to the previous, except using a different mechanism for signal decay, that of dephasing. Again, the top panels show an array of 7x7 dipoles viewed along the z-axis, with the top left viewed in the rotating frame and the top right viewed in the lab frame. The bottom timeline depicts the externally applied RF power that causes a 90-degree spin flip, and the top timeline depicts the detected signal. Unlike the previous example, in this case, there is no spin-lattice interaction of the dipoles with the external environment to cause realignment of the dipoles along the z-axis. Instead, each dipole randomly interacts with a neighboring dipole in the following crude model. The phase of one dipole is advanced by a small amount, while the phase of a random adjacent dipole is retarded by the same amount. The net effect is that over time, the phases become scrambled or dephased. Note that all dipoles remain in the transverse plane. That is, the length of the red arrows is constant, but after time, they all point in different directions. Since the antenna detects the vector sum of all transverse components, if the vectors are dephased, then the vector sum becomes very small and the signal is weak. Since the dephasing process is gradual, the effect on the signal is an exponential decay superimposed on the sinusoidal waveform. The time for this decay to reach 37% of its maximal value is defined as the T2 time.